Hi, we are
Gorka Álvarez,
Pablo Wu,
Edgar Gavarrieta,
and Ivonne García, and we are the founders of Belestial Industries Company.
We are four year 11 students from Uribarri BHI Public High School,
located in Basauri, a town near Bilbao, Basque Country, north of Spain.
And we have designed a prototype called Air Reactor.
To prevent COVID-19 disease transmission, it is very important to maintain good air renewal indoors, and due to the poor ventilation of our classrooms, we decided to create Air Reactor so we could speed up the room ventilation.
To develop our prototype, the main component used the reuse fan from old computer we have in our high school. To bind the fans together, we designed and printed these pieces, and to join these pieces we use the bolts and nuts.
We also use cables to extend the shortest one, and these metal bars were needed to give more stability to the structure. And finally, to control the air reactor, we use ultrasound sensor, Arduino Uno board, and relays to switch on different columns.
The air reactor prototype has been planned and developed by a team of four people. Nevertheless, we have been helped by our classmates on different stages of the project. First, we studied the guidelines for COVID prevention. Then, we measured the volume of our classroom so as to calculate the ventilation power necessary to properly renew the air in the classrooms and obtain a safe environment free of infection. As one of our goals was to reduce the environmental impact of our project, we decided to reuse fans from all computers we weren't using at the moment and place them in one of four windows so the ventilation could be speed up. When we obtained all the fans, we thought about a design that could fit well with the dimension of our windows and choose the fans that met the requirements for the design structure. The placement of the fans was chosen, we began designing some 3D model pieces to bind the fans together and organize the electrical cables. The pieces were designed using FreeCAD software and printed using a 3D printer. We designed two models, but finally only one of them was used. While the pieces were being printed, we welded extra long cables to the fans as they were too short for us to connect them freely. When all the binding pieces were printed, we began placing the fans and connecting them together to make the structure. The pieces were also used to protect the electrical cables from damage. Then, when everything was assembled, we welded all the cables to each column to a board. We connected it to a 12-volt power supply on an old computer to check that all the fans were working properly. The next step was to improve the stability of the prototype, and for that we placed some metal bars. In addition, we print some pieces to cover the gaps between the fans to avoid air coming out entering again. Finally, we designed and developed an electronic circuit with Arduino blocks, a programmable board and a sensor to control the air reactor. The prototype was placed in the window and we performed different tests to check the functionality of the air reactor.
After performing different tests, we have checked that the air reactor efficiently renews the air of the room and therefore ensures our safety and health.
Even though the reactor ensures a proper ventilation of the classrooms, some improvements can be made to upgrade its functions. For example, the placement of the cables can be improved, so we don't have a lot of noise here. Also, we wanted to synchronize a CO2 sensor with the boards here to automatize a bit more when it switches on and switches off. And lastly, As an experiment, we wanted to program and design a mobile app to control its function and gather data. Nevertheless, we think it's a pretty viable prototype because all the materials can be found on normal high schools and it's not very hard to do. It's a very simple development and it's pretty viable.
Developing this project, we have learned countless things. For example, working on a team and coordinating ourselves, cooperating with each other, and using our available resources the best way we can. Using theoretical information in a practical way, for example, designing and printing 3D models to make pieces. Finding alternatives and solving the problems we encountered along the development of the prototype. Applying knowledge of different fields, science, technology, engineering, arts, maths, in an integral way. And finally, sharing our knowledge with others and communicating our results.
During the project, we have developed STEM skills, which are really important to solve different problems of the society. We have used the scientific method during all the steps of the project, such as gathering information, testing of the device. We worked cooperatively and used an inquiry-based learning methodology. We have used knowledge of different disciplines, such as science, technology, with design and manufacturing, maths, calculating the fan flow, rate, voltage and intensity, and arts, designing 3D pieces and sketches in an integral way. Finally, we have improved our skills in different languages such as Basque, Spanish, and of course, English.
Our project has contributed to achieve 3 of the goals of United Nations Sustainable Development Agenda: good health and well-being, responsible consumption and production, climate action.